Look at the pig on the top shelf there. He's absolutely fantastic. He's huge. I bet he doesn't even fit on the lower shelves.
Hello everyone, it's Tiffany with Thrifting Vegas. I shop at thrift stores, estate sales, garage sales, and discount stores for items I can resell for profit on online platforms like eBay, Poshmark, and OfferUp.
I just pulled up to Goodwill and I'm on a mission. I'm looking for Talavera Mexican pottery or glass animals. Several of my subscribers have asked me to look for these specific things as Christmas presents. So let's go in and see what they have. Let's go thrifting. It's really quite cloudy today and they say there's a chance of rain, which is a good thing here in Las Vegas, where we only get about 4 inches a year, which isn't very much. So, trying not to get run over in the parking lot. It doesn't seem to be very busy from out here, but we'll see when we get in. Gonna get my mask on. Let's go inside. Let's get a cart. I brought some bags today, so let's put those in. There we go. We'll check on the color of the day, which happens to be gray. So all gray tags are 50% off. And we'll head back to the hard goods section of the store. While we do that, I'll give you my usual update. This week, I went over to the new house and I got a bit of footage of the upstairs to show you exactly what we'll be having renovated in the next few weeks. And I visited some marble showrooms and some wood showrooms, and I got a little bit of footage to show you just what kind of materials I'll be choosing. Here we are in the hard goods. Let's take a look and see what they have. Coming around the corner, the shelves look quite full. Lots of animals here, but I don't see any Talavera or glass. I do see a knight on horseback. Sadly, he's missing his lance and the horse's left front hoof is broken. But he's very cool. Some shells down here. A little night light with birds on it. Trinket boxes down here. Lots of baggies filled with bits and bobs here. We've started putting ornaments in bags. I wonder if they've got a lot of them and they just want to try to get rid of them. The thing is, it's hard to see them when they're in bags. There's Mary on the donkey. It's a quite nice figurine, but one of the donkey's ears is broken, unfortunately. Lots of little trinket trays. Not for food use. This is an interesting German candle. I see these quite often, but this one looks like it has Dopey on it from Snow White. No mention of Disney though. I think I'm gonna pop that in the cart and think about it. There's a little lighthouse tray there. It's quite fun. Lots of candles as usual. I've had quite a few subscriber questions on Glassy Baby. Glassy Baby is a votive candle holder. It looks similar to this, but it's really nice quality, sort of a submerso glass where there's a color inside the clear, and then on the bottom it actually says Glassy Baby within the glass. And I'm really not sure why they are valued so highly by collectors, but they are. It's a trend. So do be on the lookout for votive candle holders that say Glassy Baby on the bottom. They do very well. Always check this type of thing just to see if the bottom is silver. You never know. Here's the Valentine's section. With a bit of patriotic and St. Patrick's Day mixed in. Over here is Easter. Easter is starting to grow because it's the next major holiday after Christmas. Not really seeing anything I have to have over here. So let's round the corner into Christmas. This is quite a sweet little vintage material trivet for $2. But I don't see that bringing me 20, so I'm going to leave it. These bottle brush trees were all the rage last year. Yeah, this one was manufactured for Halloween, it says. This fellow should be over on the other side in Easter. Not really seeing anything new in Christmas, and it is getting a bit late in the month. We're very close to shipping deadlines now, so it is probably time for me to give up on Christmas and start focusing on St. Patrick's Day, Valentine's, and of course Easter. I'm happy to see that these shelves are very picked over, which means most of the Christmas items have already gone to new homes and not into the landfill. I've got plenty of cards, plenty of tags, plenty of bags and paper. So really, I'm all set for Christmas. That's a cheese cutter, I believe.
If you're enjoying the video, it would mean the world to me if you could give it a thumbs up, drop a comment below, and subscribe to my channel with the little red button in the bottom right-hand corner of your screen.
There's still some plates and dishes and bowls and mugs to be had in Christmas. Not as many though, right? Do you see the stacks have dwindled a lot? It's true. I'm reaching through here because I think I missed these little shell stands. Just wanted to see what they are. Purely decorative, I think. I'm going to pass on those. Here we are in the mugs. That one's fun. Here is King Mickey. This is a plastic mug with a lid. His crown is the lid. They used to sell quite well, but unfortunately, I think they've come down in value, probably only about 10 to 15 now. But I am going to pop this in the cart and check eBay solds to see what they're selling for this month. These are quite fun little carnival glass cups. Sadly, not worth much without the saucers, which I will look for in the plate section. That marigold color is quite common. Moving over into the glasses. They're nicely organized again. Confused about how to apply for a job online? Goodwill can help at no cost to you. Contact the Goodwill Career Centers at... Lots of blues and greens down at the bottom here. Again, not seeing anything I have to have today. As I always say, there's so many. If you need glasses, plates, dishes, bowls, do have a look at your local Goodwill. They always have plenty to choose from. Lots of Gibson striped bowls. Having a look for those marigold carnival glass saucers. And you'd think they would stand out and be easily seen. But I'm not seeing them, sadly. And those cups just won't sell well without them. It's a sweet little Avon cup and saucer. Don't want to lose my cart here. Let's back up with it. Where were we? This peacock bowl from England is still here. Just not comfortable shipping it though. This is quite a nice painted platter from Tunisia here. Tunisian pottery, you're looking for the brand at Lesouk. It's L-E-S-O-U-K. Those have really good resale value. That platter probably only about $12. I do like this bee bowl here. Very, very heavy though, and unfortunately I am seeing a massive chip in the side. Heading into the kitcheny bits here. Clear glass as usual. Quite like the angular look of this vase, but it's very, very lightweight. Nicely organized bowls and beakers. Please stay tuned for my haul at the end of the video. I show you everything I bought, tell you what I paid, and what I expect to get for it. Just gonna check this in case it's recycled glass. It's not. I can feel immediately it's really lightweight and not very good quality. Ooh, I really like these little glass cups. They're made in Mexico and they're really nice for dipping sauces or individual salad dressing. They come in all different colors, yellow, smoke, cranberry. Seeing this reminds me that I need a new shaker for a light blue one of these I have. So I'm going to pop this in the cart and hopefully it's a universal fit and will replace the top I have on my blue one. Looks like a very vintage reamer for juicing, $1.99. It looks like it matches that refrigerator box that I found the other day. Sadly, the reamers don't sell ever so well, so I'm going to leave that for someone else. This looks like an anchor hocking design, but it doesn't feel right. I have a feeling that might be a reproduction. Checking on the top shelf here. Checking the teapots. Oh, there's another shaker at the back here. I think I like this one even better. And this one is only 99 cents. I'm going to do a switcheroo here and put this more domed one back and take this one instead. There we go. Look at all the lids here. Goodness. This is a Temptations Baker. It's an old one. Oh no, look how sad. It's got a double crack at the back here. Unfortunately, that is really a deal breaker. Lots and lots of baking pans. That massive muffin tin is still here. I don't even know if that would fit in my oven. It's huge. Some molds. Bundt cake and a jelly mold there. Some of these Wilton pans, this one happens to be Elmo, sell really, really well. So if it's your thing you like to do, definitely check the numbers on the Wilton molds with eBay sold listings. And if you get lucky, you can make quite a good profit on those. It's the miscellaneous kitchen here, it's flatware, utensils and serveware. All sorts. Oh my gosh, look how gorgeous these fruits are. They are they capis shell? I'm not sure, but it's a jar full. I had to turn the camera off to get it down because it's really, really heavy. But I think those are capis shell fruits, and in the top there's a beautiful glass blue shell for $5.99 for the whole thing. That's really lovely. Look at the colors in that shell. Reaching up here to see what this is. I like the design, but it's a mass marketed glass bowl, as is this one, I think. Yes. And this one, the flash is wearing off. Look at the pig on the top shelf there. He's absolutely fantastic. He's huge. I bet he doesn't even fit on the lower shelves. He's really heavy. Nice resin. Such a sweet face. I have to have him. Let's see what else there is here. What's this little gravy boat hiding back here? No, that's lightweight, nothing special. Just had to check though. These are, well, those fooled me. I thought they were vintage, but they're actually reproductions. This little Merlot wine plaque is interesting. It's a bit warped, I think. I don't think it did well in the Vegas heat. And there's another one. They're both a bit warped, sort of bowed out a bit. I'll put those together so someone can see the set. Lots of frames, storage boxes, sweet little Easter hanging. Is Garrett Anderson, but sadly he's missing his baseball bat. It's broken. Is a shame. Lots of fascinating items. Baskets, plaques, boxes, huge apple. Oh, it's a Lazy Susan. That's fun. I really like these napkin holders with the, not sure what that is, the salt and pepper on the side there. They used to sell really quite well for me. I would clean up the wood and condition it, and they'd sell for $20, $30, but now, sadly, only about 15. Oh, unfortunately, this jewelry box is missing its glass. Had it not been, I would have considered that. Had a nice leather inlay there. It's a San Francisco helmet. It's very discolored. What is this up here? Oh, this, I believe, is a bike rack to where you can actually store your bike standing up. I think I'm going to pick this up for our new garage. It's heavy. Oops. Just having a look in the miscellaneous aisle. This is where they put everything that they don't know what to do with. And party supplies. Lots of paper and tablecloths. Looks like some kind of hose for the garden.
Please keep your children with you at all times. This is for their safety and the convenience of our customers.
Ceiling medallion. Can find just about anything at Goodwill. Leather conditioner set. Just don't know how old those items are though, so you have to be a bit careful. I have a Libman mop and I'm going to be using it to clean our new floors. Also, there is a tape measure here. I always manage to mislay my tape measure somewhere or another, so I'm going to pick up this one in a bag for $4. We're in the vases, checking up top first. Lots of clear. Somebody's very nice shell creation there. I wonder if it works as a vase. It's interesting. Oh, I thought that was milk glass. It's actually plastic. How funny. It's really light. Set of three blue handkerchief vases, art glass, not terribly good quality. It's a little pottery mug. That's a garlic keeper or roaster, sadly missing its lid. Some really big vases up there. This is quite a nice blue pottery one. Very heavy. Not really anything special, so I'm going to leave that one for someone else. Into the florals here. Plants and fruits. This looks like an IKEA piece. Silk plants. This looks like one of those LED trees. Sadly, it's a bit worse for wear, missing quite a few branches. And the metals. Oh, this is interesting. Pottery barn. That that's a good find. $2.99, a little vase and either a tray or a trinket dish. Definitely grab that. This is quite an interesting tray. It's very, very heavy. It's Pier 1. Let's see. I think I might grab that. Think about it. I have to put the camera down and make some room in the cart. I'll do that in a second. Once I finish looking over these shelves here, it's a little frame. Don't think I'll get a 20 out of that, so I'll leave it for someone else. While we're in this section, I have to say thank you again to one of my lovely subscribers, Jean. She sent me the anchor hocking little chip and dip metal piece I needed. It's fantastic. Thank you, Jean. Love you so much for that. And I'm on the lookout for a very cool Las Vegas mug for you. Usual racks and candle holders. This has the look of Hager, but immediately as I pick it up, I can tell by its weight that it's not Hager or Royal Hager at all. The style is right though. In the hats, and I noticed this adorable woof hat. How appropriate is that with our new German Shepherd puppy coming home in just about a month? I'm going through these shelves one more time, and I noticed this little star dish. Looks like it's really nice quality. I turn it over, and it's actually, let me see if I can show you this, Longaberger Pottery, which is a great brand. They're famous for their baskets, but they also make pottery. This is a great find. I'm spotting more Disney on the shelves. This is a grumpy old-fashioned alarm clock. He's really fun, but unfortunately he is $9.99 blue tag, which is a bit steep considering I think these barely fetch $20 online. So I'm going to leave this for someone else. I just spotted a really pretty blue vintage style pick. It's in great condition. Lovely color. 69 cents, half off, so it's 35 cents. Let's take a stroll through the art before we go. See what they have. Furniture is also this way. Sometimes they have some really interesting pieces. I am still kicking myself for not picking up that gorgeous white dresser that Danny and I found while we were here months ago. I am just so beside myself that I didn't purchase that. But I'm sure something else will come along. This looked nice from a distance, but it's not old. And sadly, it's veneered and damaged. It's a really big mirror. And over here, I saw it from the other side, is a quite elegant, I think this is known as a grandmother clock. Very nice piece, priced at $150. Look down the linen section. There's a big table there. A Rocket League cushion. I believe that is a video game. Jake has that on his Switch, I think. Lots of cushions. Lots of blankets. Quite a fun little snowflake, but we are drawing towards the end of the Christmas selling season.
This morning I'm headed over to our new house to meet with the materials person who's going to help me finalize the finishes for our new floor. Our new bathroom floors and counters and cabinets and all sorts of bits and bobs that I need to choose. So I'm going to get on the road and I'll see you there. Here we are at the new house. Let's go inside and I will take you upstairs and show you exactly what we're going to have done. Okay, first off, these stairs don't look too bad through the lens here, but when you get up close, the wood isn't very good quality and it's actually lifting in a lot of places. There's quite a bit of damage and we need it to be absolutely waterproof and dog-proof and kid-proof. And this room here is going to be my office and shipping room and inventory room for eBay. So I'm going to need it to withstand my rolling racks, which will go here by the window. I'm actually going to lose a couple of feet here because I'm going to have a laundry closet built out, a linen closet built out from the bathroom, the master bath, which is on the other side of that wall. So let me show you the kids' bathroom, which is right here. Whoops, that's the fan. Hey! So we're going to completely redo this. It's going to be a nice natural stone travertine floor, new vanity, a granite countertop. We're going to have a new bath and matching tile all the way up to the ceiling here. And it's actually going to reflect exactly what we're doing in the master bath, which is this way. This is the master bedroom. It has a lovely little nook or office space or sitting room with doors that go out onto a little balcony. Nice little sitting area. Lovely size master bedroom. And here is the bathroom. So what I'm going to do is have this monster bath removed. All new counters, all new vanities. The counter is actually going to go all the way across here into that little cutout, and it's going to be a vanity makeup station for me. The toilet will stay, this closet will actually become the shower. The entire thing is going to be a massive shower right here, because this shower is just really tiny. I don't even think Chris could fit in it. And then this shower, the existing shower, is going to become part of our shared closet here. So this wall will be knocked out, and this wall will go back a bit. And the existing shower will become part of our closet. We're going to have lovely travertine floors, granite countertops, and that's what we're going to do. I have to go choose the materials with my lovely materials lady. So that will be really fun. They're going to start demo next week, which is very exciting. And hopefully they will be done to where we can move in as planned at the beginning of January. So I am going to pop down the stairs now and take you to Goodwill. This is really exciting. I'm at the tile place looking at granite slabs. Look how beautiful this one is. This is my favorite at the moment, but I'm gonna keep looking.
Concern is how close we could. What about this one?
Had to show you this piece of granite. Isn't that amazing? It almost looks like you're underwater and it's oysters and shells. Just fascinating. Look at this slab of, is it granite? I don't know if it's granite or onyx. Isn't that gorgeous?
Here we are for the haul, and we have Ziggy with us. Ziggy has been carrying around this ribbon. Is that your favorite? It's not often that he stays in front of the camera, but he just really is enjoying this brown ribbon.
Here in front of me is everything I found at Goodwill. It wasn't a very big haul, but I'm really pleased with the pieces I found. First, we have this amazing long-legged pig. He has to be, oh, a good probably 18 inches tall. Actually, I can measure him with the brand new tape measure I found. Let's see if I can do this one-handed. Is probably just about 16 and a half or 17 inches tall. I paid $7.99 for him, and I value him about $20 to $25. I found this vase full of these gorgeous shell covered mosaic fruits. Also a couple of real shells and this beautiful iridescent blue glass I believe it to be hand-blown shell. This piece alone I value at $20 to $25. And I'm having a really hard time finding these online. I don't know whether it's because you're no longer allowed to sell items like this, but if anybody knows the value of these mosaic shell fruits, I would really appreciate it if you could let me know in the comments. I purchased this lovely blue shaker jar quite some months ago, and I've been looking for a replacement lid. Luckily enough, I found this one for a dollar, and it does actually fit on here perfectly. So now we have a lovely blue cheese shaker. Isn't this fun? It's a woof hat. It's brand new. It has a VCA on the back, and I believe that's an animal rescue. I paid $3.99 for the hat, and I value it at $20. This was a nice surprise. I purchased this little vase and flower set because the bottom said Pottery Barn. I took it apart, and the little vase is actually pewter, and it's Danforth, a signed piece. Hello, Bandit. It's a signed piece worth between $40 and $60. I picked up this little blue pick just because I like to have these on my tree. I just pop them in on the Christmas tree or in amongst a wreath or other decoration or even in my fruit bowl. You just add a splash of color. This was 69 cents gray tag on sale for 35 cents. The last couple of things I picked up for me. I have a Libman Wonder Mop. I love it. You can throw the refills in the washing machine, mop your floor, dry them out and use them again. So I thought I'll be doing quite a bit of cleaning up the old place and cleaning the new place. So these are usually about $10. This was only $3. And then my little baggie with my new tape measure, came with a regular screwdriver and a scraper. You never know when these come in handy. It's a scraper with a razor blade on it. The whole bag was $3.99. I didn't see this the first time I went through, but the second time around, I noticed that it was quite nice quality. I picked it up, turned it over, lo and behold, it is Longaberger pottery. There's the signature. Really nice little star bowl, basket weave pattern. I paid $1.99 for it, and I value it about $20. I don't always buy everything I put in my cart. Sometimes I'll pop something in there to think about it or to check the value on eBay sold listings. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. I had so much fun at Goodwill, at my new house, checking out the granite and doing the haul. If you see anything you're interested in purchasing, please drop me an email to thriftingvegas.tiffany
homel@gmail.com. And we'll see you next time. Bye.